free. So now I kind of feel bad because we were we weren't being super kind to you in the cast. Because
well, no, it's yeah. You know, it's a custom game. It's for fun.
Yeah.
Then you know it's just keep in mind that you know this is also you know all of a big test for a spectator coin. And you know what? If you ever come across people like in customs that you know super rage sometimes or get frustrated, it's like you know what? Forget them.
Yeah, if you're gonna go support, Claire, Philostone, and Cage's lucky pick for a Nidalee would probably do you very well. Tenacity either.
Yeah, this is we got an impromptu summoner support here.
Well, that's kind of what you said. You wanted to do this stuff live.
I do.
The game live.
This is yeah. Hey, you're right. So yeah. So most standard. You did your correct skill build by maxing out your healing first. But if you're playing a support role, you want your Philosopher's Stone, you want your Heart of Gold, and in some instances, you want your Kage's Lucky Pick, just so you have your GP5, just so you have your gold.
Kage,
Cages. your lucky.
Yeah, ninjas, Kage, I get it.
But actually, no, I was actually looking at the LoL wiki. It's actually, from what I understand, from what the trivia section says, it's actually a Tenacious D reference.
Oh, yeah?
KG's lucky pick from the pick of destiny.
Pick of destiny. Cool.
Yeah.
Jilt Soda actually in the stream. We just covered you yesterday, dude. Hope you enjoyed
your
video. And he just wants us to know that Teemo's mushrooms are shields, just like Captain America. So I'm going to call them shields. Holy crap, the game started.
I prefer pancakes. I mean, if it looks like, if it's in a disc form...
You call two things pancakes, though.
If it's in a disc form, in this game, it's a pancake. I don't care what anyone says.
If it's a disc, it's a pancake. Fair enough. All right, game number two here started, guys. I'm just going to get myself set up here for the VOD. 3, 2, 1. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to League of Legends. This is almost like a live summoner support series. It's because HatPerson and I just really love this game that much, and Riot loves us enough to give us a working beta spec plan, so kudos.
Excellent. So we're testing it out today as much as we can. So, and of course, you know, these are all people who semi-know each other, so but now we actually have a nice little 5v5 scrim going on.
That was weird. I did a smiley face in chat and it didn't show up.
Eh.
Oh, there it is. Okay, no worries. Yeah, so the first one was just kind of like we grabbed 10 people that we could together and, hey, it worked. So now this round, Stratto and his buddies on the left here side are going to be taking on Holy Spork and Nugs the Pirate's team. So these guys are a group of five, and I actually met Holy Spork and Nugs the Pirate out at MLG. Very cool couple. They're expecting their firstborn fairly soon, so congratulations to them. And they're going to be taking on Stratto, and look at that. Town and Graves, banned. You think that's coincidence?
I don't think so at all. But, you know, Stratto... So, for anyone who knows Stratto, his four big mains are Talon, Graves, Nidalee, and Lux.
Yep.
So, you know, we saw some of the Lux last game. Now we're going to switch it up. Top lane, Nidalee.
He really bounced back from a terrible start with Lux.
Absolutely.
He was disconnected. He started losing the mid. And in the end, he was still sniping people like a boss.
There you go. So, we got Jungle Jarvan walking in for our purple team. I don't see Jungle Jarvan as much as I used to, but you know, I do like it very much so. Just his standard going in for the pop-up, wonderful gank option there.
I don't think I've ever seen a Jungle Jarvan. I can understand it, though. He's very tanky, he has his passive for 4%, and he can double that for another 4%, make 8% deficits every few seconds. And
he's by no means the fastest jungler in the world.
No, no.
But, you know, he holds his own.
He holds, definitely. I can go with that. The flip side of bans, Amumu and Jax, which is kind of funny because you're not playing in this, so...
No, I'm not. I think Stratos is doing that to spite me.
Maybe. It's like, well, I know you're a spec, but I'm going to ban him anyways. But either way, those are the bans. We're only getting 4. Typically in a tournament game, you got 6, but here we're only going to get that 4. Morgana's now locked in for Holy Spark, so very likely a mid-hero right there. What do you think, Stratos? See, Stratos going with that strategy. I thought he was going to go with Lux, the Clarity, Clairvoyance. That's just so he can spear you. That's all. The only reason he's going to take this is so he can mana up, look for you, and then spear you. That's the entire reason he's going to take it.
And it's, you know, we had that earlier options in the last game. Where we could have CV'd for Nidalee Spears.
Yeah.
So, but now it's all... Actually, yeah, is it actually... Could he be going, Well, we also have a lunatic who also took CV and Flash, and I'm not quite sure who's going to
suspect that'll change.
Yeah. Or it could just be seeing character swap coming down the line.
So Lindos taking Irelia, so that's likely the top pick. And on the flip side, Polaris taking Ashe and Sonos, that are going to be down bottom. We do see the typical Clairvoyance Flash coming up for Sonos. We're going to have to see how they want to do. So we got our AP, we got our jungler, and we got Ashe for our AD. Who do you think we're going to have at top? Because Holy Spark did really well with that Renekton last game.
Right. I think they're going to save their top lane for their last pick. Because Morgana is just, you have to go mid with Morgana, you just got
to
do it.
Well, Morgana would have to go up against Irelia if she went top, and I don't see that happening whatsoever.
Not at all. Not at all.
I would say so. Ryze would actually probably be decent top up against Irelia, just hold her in place.
That's not too shabby.
Oh, well, they got an
idea.
Cannon.
Ooh.
Well, it's an energy hero. I can understand that you're going to get a lot of spam off, but it's very creep dependent, because they get in the way of your shuriken.
Right. So, Kennen, granted you get the skill shots off pretty frequently, I can see that happening. I think Shen may have also been a good pick as well. As we saw during yesterday's episodes, just how effective Shen can be top lane just by throwing those knives.
My music is stuttery today. I don't understand. It was fine all day, now it's just stuttery. Hmm. Weird. Either way, chat's actually bring out something nice here. We have a Morgana ult. This is probably... Okay, no. Fine. Good delay's good. We have a Morgana ult, we got a Kennen ult, we got a Sona ult. And we have...
A Jarvan ult. This could be hilarious. This can be very... Just...
Could be.
If we can get Jarvan to get just all 10 people...
in the circle?
If we can get Jarvan to get all... everyone except for Sona... in the ult. That would be hilarious.
Wow, I don't see that happening.
I'm not even sure how many people you could fit inside of this ult. I don't know, I've never
tried. Let's go for a world record like they do in Japan.
Here we go. We got a trivia question for chat. What is the maximum number of people you can trap inside Jarvan's ult? We don't know. We want to know.
There you go, guys. Go do your homework. That's fine. To finish off the blue team here, we do have Tryndamere and Caitlyn, but who's the jungle? I have to assume Tryndamere.
Tryn did have Smite up earlier, but switch over to Ignite. Like we said earlier, you can still jungle with Ignite. It's just not preferred or as efficient. He may still go jungle. I don't know.
Really don't understand what's wrong with Rainwave, but I'm going to stop the music until we go live. Either way, Caitlyn and I suspect Lux will now be down at bottom. Mm-hmm. Stratto will probably be taking mid. And we are going to stick with the two clairvoyances, so I have to assume Lux is going to be in a support capacity here. So Lux with the Caitlyn versus the Sona Ashe.
Right.
That's kind of an even, except, of course, the healing advantage. But, if we can land some decent shots, it's kind of like a Taric and Caitlyn lane. I mean, if we can get those immobilizes followed up by the burst from Lux, we can land a nice piltover and maybe even a trap under them from Caitlyn.
Yeah, the advantage we have by picking Lux instead of Taric is we have the stun. We have a slow, but instead of having a heal, we have a shield.
Yes.
So we have a little, offensive trade-off there.
I kind of like it.
We'll see how it works. We'll see how it works. If anyone's going to be there to try this with an arranged AD, Caitlyn's the one to do it with.
All right. Let's see what my music's doing this time. All right, Street. Oh, not Street Fighter, Street. Okay. Either way, we got the one exhaust from Lindos. Two exhausts, actually. Lindos and Utsuko. We got the Ignite on Cake. Holy Sport going for the Ignite. Should probably be able to pick up some nice noodly kills. And Polaris actually going for the movement, so we got Flash and Ghost.
That's what I do on Ashe myself. I'm not the best ranged AD carry in the world, but when I try, I go Ghost Flash.
Here's the thing though, we don't have an exhaust for that Tryndamere.
We do have our ignites though. We don't have an exhaust, but we have our ignites.
That doesn't help you when he's beating on your head.
Also true. Also true.
I mean, if there's anything I know about Tryndamere, is that he hurts later.
Well, we just have Jarvan ult him, and just, he'll take care of it, and then, we'll let him die, and everyone else can run.
He can die, everyone else can run. King Tryndamere, no, nonetheless. Cake Nom Nom taking that.
So, it's like, who cares about the prince? We got the king.
I have to still assume Cake is going to be jungling. Even without that smite, he can still do up a decent jungle route, but he won't be starting at blue unless he gets a super leash.
Which I'm not sure if he's going to get.
So he might start off at maybe at the golems with a leash or the wraith.
I can see him starting off at small golems and going for a level 2 gank.
Because otherwise we're going to have Irelia and Tryndamere top, and that just sounds not optimal.
No. Well, in most games, you know, the optimal build for pretty much every game, solo top, solo mid, carry and support bot, and jungle, because you just maximize your experience gain that way. That's just how it goes.
This is one MOBA where tri-lanes just do not work.
Yeah, it's, you know, granted that's not as entertaining, but you know what? Different MOBAs require, you know, different strats, different metagames.
Oh, the Han community is kind of sick of the tri-game. they're actually moving more towards back to a 2-1-2. Actually, all weekend I was seeing a 2-2-1 with a dual lane mid.
Really?
But sometimes we have some junglers. Very rarely do you see those tri-lanes anymore, so it's kind of funny how they're now evolving out of it. But
How frequently do people jungle in Han, if at all? There's only, like, what, like 2 or 3 champs that really can?
No, there's a lot more than that. But, yeah, the frequency of it, it's not super high yet, but it's coming back more into focus. Really, we get 10 bans in Heroes of Endurance, so...
Yeah.
There's a lot of, like, if you really just don't want to deal with the jungle, there are ways to eliminate that, but... Yeah, no worries. I'm going to say Caitlyn got disconnected.
Yeah, they're saying in chat Caitlyn got DC'd. We should see her back here.
I had to get rid of chat. Yeah. You can, if you hit enter, the little blue bar comes up, you can actually move it around.
Yep.
Yeah. Alright, so guys, it is going to be a scrim. It does look like the spec client is working for us, but this is now the second game in a row where we've had somebody not load up, and I have heard of these kind of situations before. Hopefully he'll be back here within time. Now, Stratto is going to find Nugs, going to take a few shots at her. Nugs versus Stratto, 1v1. Nugs does not seem to be actually at her computer.
Yeah, we're not going to...
There we go.
Spear. Oh, force her back. Not, you know, just kind of, you know, friendly. Why should I use your potion? Use your potion! Why'd you use your potion to get it back anyway?
Oh, he didn't predict that. I thought he was going to look for her with the clairvoyance to get the kill and be like, that's why you do that. But he didn't.
Yeah.
Alright, minions are spawning. Lindos is up here. Does look like Trin will be jungling even without that smite, so he does have Ignite instead, something to keep aware of. But here's that leash coming out, and it will be on the Wraith, so he will be starting here. And he took the Bloodlust first, so the heal.
Yeah, our Caitlyn, unfortunately, is still not back yet. I hope she gets back here soon. Otherwise, you know, unfortunately, we're just going to have Stratto with a totally, you know, totally baller niddly play.
Yeah.
Take it on two. I don't know how he's ever going to do it. It is Stratto. We'll see. Have to see.
Now, Jarvan able to pick up the blue. Fairly short order. And he's going to start his route. And yeah, everyone seems to be engaging very nicely. It is going to be Morgana top up against that Irelia. Interesting. They have to have a lot of confidence that you know we can get this Irelia, you know, under-farmed. And I just don't see it. I mean, maybe they're going to prove me wrong. I would say Irelia would easily beat this lane because of her distance closers.
Right. Oh, we got Sona coming in, warding the bottom bush, just so Shadow can't comfortably hide down there.
Very common move. Now we do have Kate coming up here. We are playing really interestingly here on Spork. We're just going to go right up to him. Good stun. Here goes the flash.
Chicken.
Exhaust and an ignite at the first blood.
There we go. Tryndamere she's got the Bloodlust and the spin. Doesn't even have the chicken.
That's gonna be
didn't even need it. Did not even need it.
Level 2. He doesn't have the chicken at level 2.
This is true. This is true. I like chickens.
I like
what can
you
I say?
Too. Yeah, don't worry. so that's gonna be fantastic for Tryndamere. I mean, there are still down this player. All Utsicles still not here.
But also, boss learning pretty quickly that can't quite take blue just yet.
He can't take blue, but we did have a ping go down on red. Here we go. Here's Utsuko. So 3.5 minutes in. He's going to be down about 2 levels, but Strato's doing actually some great work down here. He's holding the entire lane by himself. Now, this is what he does. He goes into the bushes. He's going to try to fake you out. He does have clarity and clairvoyance. So there's going to be no shortage of spears, and he's just going to try to find that perfect angle and just harass the hell out of you. Except, of course, when you get hit like that.
Right. I am noticing, so Jarvan's coming up from trying for a gank. He's got double buff, but Aurelia's being pushed too far back. But I've also noticed that Tryndamere in jungle is very reliant on multiple leashes for all of his jungle mobs without having smite.
Well, Cake went back to town. Yes, he has 800 gold to his name, but he didn't even buy boots. So maybe he's going to go for that quick wriggles.
That would be a pretty good idea. I'm not opposed to that.
Now the sneaky dark sniper did come in here for a little bit of damage, landed a bit here on Lindos, but he's going to go back. He needs to keep resuming that jungle. Holy Spark should be all right for now. It does have a ward out as well, so that's very good on him. He's not wanting to get ganked again, and Utsuko now level 1. He's going to have to play very passive.
So we got Stratto. You know, forget the support role. Just, you know, keep on going in, just throwing as many spears as he can. Kayla's just kind of like there now. You know, she'll be around, she'll be getting the XP, but Stratto is now having to man up, take the carrier role, bottom lane.
Well, he's done alright. He has 14 creep kills, but he's focused a lot on just keeping them from being super aggressive. So his farm...
He's also built up his spear to level 3 first, you know, trying to take down that role as the main damage dealer in this lane.
Yeah, well,
I think he's also kind of forgotten that bush is indeed warded.
Well, when the minions start attacking, he'll figure it out.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I mean, you gotta deal the cards that you do get dealt. Now, we don't have a ward here, so we're not gonna know that Jarvan's coming behind us, but what is Jarvan gonna do? Flagon?
Caitlyn goes back. Stratto runs forward. I don't know. That bush is warded too now.
That, and there was a clairvoyance there. I mean, it's right there. If I saw it go down, he should have, but I guess a little bit overconfident. Well. This should give Utsuko some nice solo experience, though.
That is Stratto being Stratto, though. Just trying to be that Rambo, trying to be that solo one-man army.
All right, now Lindos has gone back to town, picks himself up the Philo Stone and some boots. So he should be doing fantastic here top lane, especially with his heightened style, giving him a lot of that life back. And we should see some aggression coming out onto the Holy Spark soon, simply because he's now pushed really far forward. So actually it might be a really good time for him to go back to town or just land a nice dark binding. Huh?
So Tryndamere is just, you know, trying to slowly make his way through the jungle. At least he still does kind of need a little bit of support, you know, occasional leash from Lux every once in a while for the main mobs.
Well, he has his blue boots now with the Avarice, so still with that Vampiric, not going for that fast wriggle.
Purple team has pinged this bush right down here, so they are aware that it is warded.
Yep. Well, Stratto definitely doesn't want that happen again. Oh, good spear on the Nugs right there. And he went back to town, got himself a Sapphire Crystal.
See, that's, let's see, what could we be... Could we be seeing a Rite of Ages?
Very possible.
Early Banshees
doesn't seem very feasible.
Nah. I don't think that's going to be what we're looking at. But I think we are also aware that this Jarvan, you know, this Jarvan just kind of chilling in this bush, doesn't know that's warded. No communication to the contrary. So Aurelia's just going to kind of be playing a little bit careful here, and while she's stunning Morgana, Jarvan's just kind of chilling.
Yep.
Watching. Yeah.
Chilling,
recalling.
Like
kind of lazy.
Now Lindos is using his Q here to land you know, those last hits. As often. Right. Oh, good timing! Jarvan good. Just left the lane, goes right
Black
up here.
Black shield just in time. Gets the ult off. We could have some...
Double kill.
Oh, man. Haymakers. Double haymaker all over the place. Aurelia gets a kill, but she's standing on that soil.
Actually, believe it or not, Morgana was listed as the first kill there. So I wonder who got the experience. And look at that, Stratto picking up that blue buff. That's not going to be very impressive here for Sneaky Dark Sniper, because they did have it warded. He's going, oh, no blue buff, and a spear just to have him on his way.
So it was like, hey, there's no blue here. I wonder who took it.
Yep.
Whoosh.
The spear goes by my head. Yep. This just means 4 spears for these guys to dodge down south.
I am not opposed to more spears, especially if Shredo's the one throwing them.
How much magic pen does that guy have? I have to wonder. But yeah, he's just going to be a machine gun of spears at this point. It's going to be like a rapid fire crossbow.
Jarvan kind of, Jarvan, knowing that bush is warded, goes through the dragon area down to the bush. Coming up behind Caitlyn and Nidalee here, going for the attempted gank.
Oh, the arrow!
Coming down on Caitlyn. We got the standard, we got the pop-up. Caitlyn in a whole lot of trouble right now, getting slid a little bit by Ash.
Oh.
Misses the ult just barely.
And the exhaust goes out just to boot. Look at that, defensive spear coming up from Stratto, landing right snugly into Nux's face.
Now Sona levels, and now she has her ult. We could have used, if she gained that experience just a little bit before, that fight could have gone so much differently.
Lux is down here now as well, looking for a little bit of that pie. But, that spear would have hurt. But now that's probably going to be the end of that. Cannon in the mid, but we do got Cake here.
Still have Sona ult available to us. We could still make something of this, but Jarvan's just going to go ahead and recall back. He's not going to sweat it.
Nope. Big spear.
Oh, standing still on Sona.
That's going to be the entire game, just us seeing if he hits Nugs with the spears. Yep.
Oh,
he has ridiculous accuracy.
Taking a hit for the bro. Laser coming up. Oh.
Oh, they actually comboed that?
Actually comboed it.
I missed it.
Ah.
Now, this is why you don't let Strata go Nidalee. It's like the next Cha-Cha GG meme. Man.
Most the kill actually goes a credit to Lunatic here, coming in from that river bush, getting the stun and the laser. Mm-hmm. And you know, just three people mid. That's, you know, what else can you do than just kind of take it?
Maybe a dead cannon, that's for sure.
It's a dead lightning rodent.
Lightning rodent. That's a terrible way to name that.
Hey, that's what Joshy says.
Is it? Well, if Joshy says it, must be true.
If Joshy says it, it's cool.
Yeah, no worries. So now we have a little bit of reverse here. Their jungle now has to sit here in the mid and kind of babysit it, but he's going to take a lot of combo damage from Lunatic. Oh, Lunatic has the sword shoes. That's it, baby. But 34 ability combo power.
Down. He's got that combo down, but he's got no mana left. He's going to have the back. But, you know, we do take the bottom turret for ourselves here.
Yep. Top.
So now, see how much gold we got to spend here. Yeah, so Strato's got a sizable amount of gold to go spend. Caitlyn's, you know, got... Oh, she's almost got a BF sword. Because, you know, get one or two more kills, she can buy it.
If you notice, like, he came in 4 minutes late to the game, but is the same level as the enemy Ash. Yep.
So let's look at the creep kills here.
In fact, 2,200 gold to 2,400. She's only 200 gold under Ash.
That's not too shabby.
10 creeps under Ash. That's it.
My thing is, though, what will she buy? Will she buy BF sword? Will she get, like, another Doran's and boots?
I highly suspect the BF sword.
Ah, boots. Boots and a pickaxe.
She's going to start the Infinity anyway.
Yes. Yeah, we're going to be building gradually to Infinity Edge, so we might as well.
So many Nidalee traps. Nidalee traps. Caitlyn traps. We got spears and lasers and kill secured. Oh, my God.
Oh my.
Yep. Now
Morgana's pushing quite a bit, but, you know, she has her ward. She's, you know, somewhat protected.
Oh, good shot.
Good dark binding on her, but let's see, why is Aurelia a level on her Morgana?
Because went and killed Cannon.
Ah, okay, that would explain it. She has 2-1.
Yep.
Morgana does have the superior creep kill, though.
Actually, they got two kills on Holy Spork, if you remember. Like, the first blood with Jarvan, and then they killed each other.
Yes, this is true.
Yep. So, no, she's doing actually really well. Went back to town, got herself a Sheen. That's just going to make her Q hit just that much harder. That will probably catch her up in the farm fairly quickly. We're at, what, 6877? Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Next creep wave alone should be able to do it. Although, you know, Vision Ward and Sight Ward now for Morgana. She has herself that Blasting Wand, so maybe she will be going for that hat first.
I would like to see that. I would love to see that.
What's our little Yordle friend doing? Will the Ancients? So took that Gunblade, or Revolver. Took the Hextech Revolver, made it into the Will of the Ancients. So
which is going to help. That's going to be fantastic. if you're just kind of in lane with Morgana. Because you know, Morgana already has her built-in passive spell vamp.
Yep.
Get her next to that cannon.
Oh, looks like you're going to go for KO for Lindos, but Lindos does hurt quite a bit. The Binding and the Tormented Soil. Did we already? Yeah, we just threw down.
Oh, and we got Jarvan trying to get his own blue, but Stratto and Lunatic are harassing him.
Oh, he lights it out.
Yeah, unlike last time, you know,
you can see the power of the double.
Stratto unable to steal the buff this time around. Yeah, just throwing spears just for the hell of it now, though.
Yep.
Ash Arrow coming in, totally blind in there.
Oh, how did he get out of that?
Defense. Jarvan with that ult flashes behind. Lux to just auto-attack that kill.
Utsuko could be in trouble. But there's a cake nom-nom right there!
The Trend is there.
Goes for the Ash, very wise.
Premier in a bush.
Big damage going down, but now he's going to have to pop that
ult. He's loaded. He's got the rage. He can't do anything with it. Ash is going to be holding tight.
He still only has that tier 1 boots. He's not exactly the fastest of movers.
Ash flashed away. She had to burn and just get away.
Oh, we had our ult. Utsuko has his ult. Why did he not use it?
I don't know.
Oh, that seems kind of silly.
It's unfortunate.
It's like we're watching Riven all over again. From yesterday. Alright, well,
but Jarvan's just gonna go in right here for Dragon, but doesn't know it's warded.
It's warded, but we got no teleport.
Although we don't. Stratto's sticking up behind.
Go! Oh!
Yes! Here! Auto attack gets it.
And you know the Dragon!
Before we got the dragon pretty unhealthy, we might as well just finish it up. A kill plus dragon.
And red and blue.
And red and blue, that's pretty good.
Stratto has to be very happy about that.
Stratto's very happy about that. I already know. He's probably dancing.
He's dancing. Here's the clairvoyant! Oh, look at the spear!
Look at that spear on Sona. Ouch.
Yep. She's
that was pretty. That was how much health?
Too much.
That was like a 500 shot, man.
Let's check it out. Arrow!
Spooked! Stratto! We're seeing the sexy diddly play that Stratto here is known for.
Oh, Stratto's too good. Too good.
Alright, so we got... Kennen is backing. I guess we're buying... we're upgrading to movement 3 boots here from Kennen. Just barely has enough.
Picked up another Doran's here for Mr. Utsuko after getting those Berserkers. So, I mean, he has a Sight Ward. Still only that pickaxe, so a little bit late on the BF. He's not going to get that Infinity by 20 unless somehow he gets a whole bunch of random kills.
So Kennen bought Movement 3 boots instead of Magic Pen boots. And we're also defensive. We're getting a Negatron Cloak, I think, out of fear for Nidalee.
Yes. Negatron Cloak. Definitely, I would say, from that... Well, Nidalee, Lux... Yeah, just Nidalee.
You know, it's not helping that much. Wow. There's a shot for 300, 400.
250% times... it's about 250, so yeah, you can definitely get up there. Lindo's still going for some harass. Does miss the Dark Binding. So yeah, this top lane, they're just kind of life-stewing each other. It's not really going to go anywhere.
Yeah.
Now, Tryndamere is going to come in here. He is going to find Jarvan, or at least Jarvan's going to find him.
Lux pincering into Jarvan with the laser, almost gets him. Can't standard over quick enough.
Here comes that second clairvoyance coming out. He's going to go for the kill. Oh, he's going to hit the...
And all the while, Tryndamere is just going to go ahead, take their red.
I see what you did there.
Aurelia taking the top tower. Our purple team is just kind of on the ropes for the time being. They're just hugging towers. They can't really do much of anything. They can. They see Stratto hanging out.
Arrow
on Lux, but they can't really capitalize on it much.
Kennen might be able.
Here comes Kennen in with the ult.
Sona stunned.
Sona
win.
Done. That's a double.
That was a Morgana. Oh no, that was not a Morgana ult.
Oh, it's the. I wasn't. Didn't.
It was
on cooldown. It was on cooldown.
Gonk over another 5 seconds.
Okay, but you know what? This is a perfect opportunity to get take the timing and just push mid. Get Morgana down to mid. Get Jarvan up to mid. If we can get a 5-man push on mid, that'd be fantastic.
But
Aurelian Fringe just come from behind.
Lindo's taking a lot of damage.
This tower This tower's OP.
Well, no, that was Zeelman really just landing a ton of damage on Aurelia.
Oh, Morgana just barely.
Did she use flash for that? She did.
She flashed for it, almost had it. Jarvan, though, pushing bot. It's a full health tower. I'm not sure how much damage he's going to do to that.
He has his Rigos, he has his Philo. Not exactly any kind of big damage after that. Stratto's going to be coming in here. Does not have the blue, but he should be able to land a nice arrow.
That's a spear. Yeah. That's Stratto.
Oh, we got Lux behind coming in, though. This could be very dangerous for him. Does a dodge it. Fortunately, the slow banner's out. Brilliant banner. But now he does not have that for this ledge. Could have used it a lot, but he might use the flash. No, he is just going to try to dodge it out. Stratto, of course, is Nidalee. It's kind of really hard to get across that, but Jukes
another spear.
Jukaruski, he's going to go right through it.
Wow, that was hairy. That was really hairy. If he didn't dodge both of those spears, he would have been long gone.
Good awareness here from the sneaky dark sniper.
Yep. But I will have to say, though, that that attempt on a full health bot tower alone, incredibly risky. I would say not even really worth attempting.
I got a lot of damage on it. Should be very.
Got a lot of damage on it. I mean, it's man, a lesser skilled player would have just died so early on.
True enough. Now we do got a big arrow.
That was a very convenient arrow right while she was in tower range, taking tower hits.
Yep. Now she's in full retreat though. We do got Fem Squad coming, Stratto and Lunatic. Here goes the one clairvoyance. Looking for the spear. Spear is going to miss because we do see the clairvoyance. Good idea backing on up there. Lunatic is going to unfortunately miss as well with both skill shots. Could take some return damage here from Polaris. Now Polaris, you know, pickaxe, double Doran's, and the BF sword. It's almost like I'm looking at Caitlyn actually. Very similar items between the two of them. 95 to 92 for the creep kills in that terms, but you know, 131 for Morgana, 132 for Cannon. In answer to that, Lindos at 122, creep cake on that Trinidad at 102. So despite that, we still got a little bit of a gold advantage here for our blue team, about 2,000 gold or so, because of that, most likely because of that tower. I mean, that's a good 600 or so right there.
Can
actually,
we,
that's 1,000 right there, 190 by 5.
I propose we take our blue team and give them the nickname Charlie's Angels.
Because
we have our Tryndamere, we got Charlie, and his four angels.
There's four angels in Charlie's Angels?
there's four angels now.
Okay, fair enough. Charlie's Angels.
He's so good, he's got a fourth angel.
Fair enough. I don't even know what we would call blue team, or purple team, but... We fail at dodgeball?
Different strokes.
I like the dodgeball because they're not dodging these spears. We fail a dodgeball. Yeah. You gotta grab life by the horns, but it's a metaphor. But I really did it. So. That movie's so hilarious. Either way, you know, purple team is now gathered up here. They do see Cake hitting this dragon. Long range support coming out from the Lunatic. They are gonna chase him off. We're not really in any kind of position to contest it. Free dragon right there. That's gonna almost tie up the game. 1,000 gold awarded, and you know. Might be dicey, although look at this good collapse, but we don't have Stratto, so it is going to be a 5-on-4. If they do decide to engage, they're going to have to poke around, but look at that Dark Sniper coming in here, has to go for that ultimate, but Lindos is down. We are going to go for the ultimate, but the flash is well-timed, and Ashe is indeed going to live.
Cake just complete missed opportunity to use his ult. He just died too quick.
Stratto face-checking? Terrible idea.
Yeah, face checking. Hey, all the new players out there, here's what you do when you were considering a face check. But you know, those are like our Trindamere flowchart from last night. Are you thinking about face checking? Don't face check. Are you going to face check? Don't face check. Never face check unless you got people with you.
It's easy to check. They got two clairvoyances.
Right.
But
I still can't believe Cake missed his ult.
Yeah.
Just got blown up. You get blown up sometimes. It happens. Don't worry about it.
So, not the best of engagements right there, but now we've taken the tower lead, we've taken the kill lead, we've taken the gold lead, and we got to be feeling really good about that here for the purple.
That was a fantastic team fight in favor of the purple team. That was, three for nothing? Four for nothing?
Lindos, Cake, and Stratto, yes. Three for nothing.
Plus three for nothing. And plus a dragon. And tower.
Two turrets. We just lost this bottom one and the second mid one.
Fantastic equity, man.
Yeah, it's great. I mean, we were down 2K, now we're up by 1. Easy as that.
That's good. That's good math. That's good math no matter how you roll it.
Anything for a positive. Anything for a positive.
There you go. WCW.
All right, 24 minutes in. Still no hat. No Rabidons from Organa. She actually might be going to go at... No, not enough. Okay, fine. Sheen now picked up, however, for Jarvan, so he's going to start working on that Triforce after his two GP10s. So, you know, pretty typical stuff. Ash does have that Infinity, and it does look like we are going to be looking at the Shirelias fairly soon here for Sona. And a Deathfire. No, sorry, an Abyssal. Not a Deathfire. An Abyssal for Mr. Kennen.
That's a good call, I think so. Because... The Abyssal is not percentage based. Yeah, damn it.
Sorry.
The Abyssal it does not take a percentage of magic users and stuff. It's a flat number. 20. And seeing as we have a team that's not really built much magic resist.
They don't have any, actually.
They have nothing, we have one Merc Treads.
We do?
That alone is gonna cut Strato's magic D in half.
We just had an Ash Arrow, but it did not land on anything. Oh, this could be bad. Big laser, good flash right there.
Darvin flashes just in time. Kennen ult going to track down Stratto.
Going for the third. Third angel. Will pay.
All of our angels already going to be going down. It looks like it.
Four angels. And... No, cakes up top.
And Trindamere's chilling.
Now, he was not even near there. He was pushing top. And now we do got five very angry people at our front door. And he's going to have to answer that with the blue buff and his newly acquired Infinity Edge.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think this is going to work out for him.
his ult is up, but, I mean, I'm not sure how effective it's going to be here in a 5v1. I mean, I know he's a beast. I know he's the king.
He's dancing. Lunatic's in here, could go for a laser, instead gonna go for the slows. Morgana, however, might be able to do something about it. No, is gonna have to back off. The entire team is now up. Lindos is gonna be joining the fight just now. It's a good time to get out. That is exactly what Purple Team's gonna be doing. This could be an opportune moment to go grab a dragon if it wasn't down, or hit on back for some of those new items. I wouldn't say Baron, though. Baron's a little too risky at this point.
Yeah, Baron is way too risky at this point, unless we can get, you know, visual confirmation on blue team that, like, maybe two of their members are at bot lane.
Doing the enemy jungle, Baron's however, risky. Holy Spark, was not one of the things I listed.
Right.
Oh, no, maybe it's going to be Polaris going down, but he has that arrow, but Lindo's not going to be taking too much of that CC because that passes.
Spear finishes off Morgana.
Two kill, as easy as that. I didn't list that, Holy Spark. What are you doing, dude? Two free kills that could have been clearly avoided right there.
And you know what? Now Kennen's going to try his luck chain out of top tower on his own. Being a man. But you know what? It's going to be going down pretty easy.
Yep.
Just need to get those last few taps on it. And no one is really diverting attention from mid. They're concentrating on that mid tower right now. Getting that first one down. Really just kind of taking it like a boss. Get those last few hits high, that'll fall.
That will clear all the tier 1 towers now in the game, and yo.
Darvin's about to get sandwiched here, going for blue buff.
Well, he did get the buff.
Aurelia, but Stratto backed off.
That's uncharacteristic of him.
It is.
Lindo's going for kill. Look at that cross-court laser. Not going to be enough, but Cake is going to come over here and steal those buffs. Good flash out of him.
Fantastic flash.
Where did Kennen go? Kennen is not pushing top. Kennen actually came back to town. Oh, that's a very missed opportunity there to get that split push going. Could have easily picked up this turret. Instead, looks like maybe it'll go down. Either way, oh, Polaris down. Cake already using that ult. Oh, he will take out Spork again. There's no exhaust. Oof. No exhaust for that Trindamere.
Guys, got a little bit ballsy. Was going, was hoping that his rage and health would save him, but unfortunately, not enough.
Now,
we're trying to track down this Kennen, though. It's being very elusive, very slippery. As slippery as lightning can be, which is very. Laser miss. Good, good. That was a good attempt.
There we go.
Where's your spear?
Oh, that would have so killed him.
Oh, you little rodent. You little rat. You're so lucky.
You call him a rodent?
Little rodent.
That's good Jukariskis right there from Zeelman. But yeah, in all honesty, he probably shouldn't have lived.
Jarvan, getting stunned. Lox is ridiculously low with no mana. I'm not sure how effective she's going to be. Stratto at this point is just going to train to get away.
Oh!
Up past the arrow.
Is he gonna, Lindell's going to come in. Going for the squishy, totally ignoring Jarvan. Might be able to pick up the return kill on top of Polaris. Maybe not. The Sona ult is going to say otherwise. Cake is in here, though. He's going to pick up that kill, but now he's going for 3-on-1.
His ult is back up, but he's done during the entire duration.
No fury.
Oh, no, he doesn't.
No fury means auto no attack. Heal for you, sir.
Yep. He got the spin, but...
No win.
Spin to lose.
That just doesn't sound as catchy.
It doesn't. Really doesn't. I take it back.
Take it back. Alright. Lux is going to go for some poke. This is about the only defense they can offer at this point. Although, look at this creep wave. It will finish off this tower. Down south, the top wave probably going to finish off this tower right now. And bam, there it goes. Two free towers without any kind of interaction. That's a whole bunch of gold in the pocket. And look at that, 42.
They didn't have to do anything. They just have to let their minions do all the work.
42 to 37,000. I mean, a lot of gold in your pocket for no work.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, a lot of that gold going to Jarvan and Kennen. Actually, pretty much, look at the gold disparity among individuals here.
9,000, 8,000,
6,000. Aurelia and Tryndamere are kind of up to par to the enemy team.
Yeah,
but Italy, Lux is actually making less money than Sona.
So Zeelman going, wow, for the kill right there. 337 ability power grabs him a double and a triple coming out in total, like two for the Morgana. And we're picking up Zeelman. I don't know, I thought maybe he figured he was dead, going to go for as much damage as possible, but it ends up getting a triple with the help of his team, totally turning the situation around. And that's three very quickly dead blue team members. This might actually be game.
You know what? This is kind of looking like it. I mean, we got the inhibitor being pushed. Look at the top tower. We got this huge, we got the minion waves just filtering on in both ends. Man. Inhibitor's down. I think, you know what? Everyone on purple team's up. We can loop around. I think now would be a great time to do Baron for purple team.
I don't know. We have everyone just respawning now. Lindos will be up in just a second. And again, we have two clairvoyances available, right?
We're
one. We can see they're going up here, so maybe already we're tipped off. But it could be a fake out, because I don't actually see anyone else going there.
Right. And Morgana's still chilling out in mid lane for a little bit, just trying to see what the R team's doing.
Okay, maybe gonna
get ballsy. This is not working in your advantage.
Not working at all in their advantage. Wow. This cannon is hurting. He has himself that Rabidon. He's at 500 ability power. You know that hurts.
That does hurt. Hurts quite a bit.
So it's kind of a poke.
Jarvan doesn't even need to be there.
No. Jarvan's not a poke. Here we go.
Now we're going for the Baron push. We have, if we can take this out quickly and effectively, if we get, we have our ward. We have one ward right down here. We have CV. We have one ward here. Ward there. We can see any advances. Our CV is up. I think we can...
Oh, why did we split? Utsukul, terrible positioning. Yeah. Lindo's getting caught in it.
Now we get Baron. Now we get Baron even... Or we, hell, we could just probably push to win at this point.
It's
good to know Stratto still hurts, though. That was half of Morgana's health.
Well, that Void Staff, after the Void Staff, he has himself a tier, but he never actually comboed it to anything. He has the full bonus mana out of it, and all he has really is a Blasting One, so he didn't exactly build super carry like we were expecting. He's at 7,000 gold, but just the gold difference at this point is about to hit that 5k mark.
That's good attempt to try and steal it, but...
Did I say 5k? I totally meant 10k. Cake actually able to pick up a kill amongst there.
Cake got something, but you know what? I'm not sure how much longer our blue team can hold out on this. Stratto, fine. Can he get popped up? That was a super pop-up. You see how far Stratto flew up into the air? I love it when that happens sometimes, even though it's really mad annoying. Lux is getting trapped. Shuriken, zap, done.
528 ability power.
I think we're now kind of... we're taking their blue, and then we're just going to push to win at this point.
Starting to snowball pretty heavy. 28 to 17 for the kills. 10,000 gold now. And a good amount of item advantage at this point.
Yeah. I think at this point, purple team can just go ahead, take that Baron, just push right down the center, and just end it right now.
Well, I mean, in retaliation to all this, Lindos went and picked himself up a Frozen Heart, and now building a little bit of magic resist. Might have went wider to go the other way. I mean, Morgana's at 9-4, and Kennen's at 7-1, and that's just pure AP damage. That Frozen Heart is virtually useless against them.
Pretty much.
And at the same time, I mean, Trendyber and Caitlyn both got their Infinities. We got the Phantoms. Actually, we don't have a Phantom on Caitlyn. Sort of out of place. Usually,
yeah,
we got our
Infinity Edge. We had a Vampiric Scepter. I think what we were doing, I think we were trying to build. See, she has 1,000 gold stored up. I think so what we're trying to do is try to build to a Bloodthirster. Yeah. But we just never quite got
0,
there.
0-2-3. I mean, she had a rough start. Yeah. She hasn't actually been able to land a kill.
I just, you know, get a few more creeps and we could buy a Zeal, but you know,
I would have went
to
movement speed. No, looking at this game.
Yeah, I think at this point though, it's a little bit too late.
Like a cake doing a duel there.
Bursted cake too quick for him to ult.
That was a big burst. 636 ability power.
Damn.
Yeah.
Damn.
Has himself another needlessly large rod. Could be very well Zonia's at this point.
Look how much that shuriken does.
Yeah, it does.
700 damage on a shuriken.
Yep.
450 damage for, oh my god.
Looks like we killed Lux. I don't know where we killed Lux. I can't find her body, but she's dead. So.
She's dead somewhere.
She's dead somewhere. Oh, well, maybe. Oh, Holy Spark showing off his Zonia is actually going to keep him alive. Nidalee going to go, but going down. Oddsicle is now down as well. Lindos, the only survivor by a smidgen, and now we are going to be pushing down to win. That would be GG well played right there. So there you go. Holy Spork and Doug's Apart, husband-wife team with their friends. They know how to play this game, guys.
They do. Very impressive. And you know what? Our purple team was trailing a little bit at the beginning, but you know what? They recovered very nicely.
Yeah. We had a little bit of a rough start for Caitlyn. Didn't really get this blossom as much as she wanted. Despite the awesomeness that is the Stratto, this will be a loss. So, game number two. Maybe we can get a game without disconnects, but this seems to be an integrated feature at this point.
Victory. Yeah. It's like, we guarantee one disconnect.
We guarantee it. Alright guys, game number two done. FourCourtJester and HatPerson. You can find us on the Twitters, the Twitch, the YouTubes, the Facebooks. And I don't know, are we going to be doing another one?
Oh, well, that depends if we can get another full 10.
Feeder Ash. I'm just reading the chat. Ash is 6-6-16. Hardly a name.
I wouldn't say that.
Yeah. Oh, they've already all left. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Fine, fair enough. Alright guys, going to take a quick break here as we go find out what we're going to be doing. So stick around, HatPerson FourCourt, entertaining you all night with this summoner mode. Be right back. Okay, I think the commercials run, but they can still hear us for people that aren't on commercials.
Or ad block.
Or ad block, yeah.
I found that out during Canada Cup. Actually, Yoon was actually at Canada Cup spectating.
Oh, in Calgary?
Yeah. Let's see, I accepted Stratos. Yep, there we go.
Oh, is there a game invite? Oh,
yep.
There is. Cool. Jigafichu. Jigashifu. Alright, the ad's probably done by now, guys. We're just gonna leave up that, Caster Splash as it looks like we're getting a rematch going. Ooh, is this a rematch? Are we done what? I know. It does look like another game is starting up, guys. But hey, we're here. We're looking at the chat. You might not see it, but we are. So go ahead. Ask any kind of questions you want. We are here for a little bit. And yeah, we're pretty much
I do need a new computer chair. Mine is way too freaking squeaky. Yeah, this thing's freaking ancient, man. Yeah, so this is the first thing I do when I head out to the West Coast. I'm just going to get myself a nice, brand new, comfy computer chair. And I'll sleep in it if I have to. No.
We were talking to Dyrus on the Beyond the Rift podcast last night.
Mm-hmm.
And he's just like, yeah, well, okay, sorry, he says it in his very monotone voice, like, yeah, I got a bed now. Like, well, what do you sleep on? The floor. Just like, okay, why'd you move out there without a bed? Just like, I get cranky in the morning for no reason. Yeah. I can't do a Dyrus voice. His voice is just bloody amazing. Have you ever heard Dyrus?
Yes, yes I have.
Oh my god. We got him to tell us a story. He's just reading like a Reddit post from the whole CDE, or the whole MLG disqualification. And he read it to us, and he has absolutely no points of inflection in his voice whatsoever. It's just pure monotone. It was hilarious.
We were talking to him at IPL 3. He keeps that tone. The only time he broke out of that tone was during one of the post-game interviews where people's moms were being brought up. That one.
What am I supposed to think when you tell me that? Check my Twitch messages. I have Twitch messages? Apparently I have messages. Well, I have a lot of messages. Oh, I got friggin' Wet Dream spamming me. Oh, an 8mm. Okay. We actually did get a little bit of emotion out of Dyrus, believe it or not, during our interviews when we were talking about his AD Sona. Phantom Lord was asking about his AD Sona, and he kind of got a little bit defensive, but his voice went up a few notches, and then afterwards it just went back down and never rose again. He was a great guest, though. Funny man.
Yeah, man. I love Atlanta. Because he's just, like, one of the funniest guys in the scene right now. Like, I remember, like, he was just spectating with us all day, too, at IPL during those Heimerdinger games. And he was just, like, making comments for everybody. Just like, guys, we have access to a tournament realm. You're not using skins. What's wrong with all of you?
Just like, you have all the skins at your disposal. Why don't you use one? Those people are just lazy.
Atlanta is just a fantastic, hilarious guy. We need more people like that in the LoL scene.
HatPerson and I are commentating. HTTP Twitch TV FourCourtJester. Ah, crap. I don't have enough to put League of Legends in that. League of Legends, I need 7 spots. Game 3 of Spectator Madness. In League of Legends with GG Stratto heading it up, HatPerson and I commentating. Bam. Done. Like a boss. Alright, so we got 10 in here. We got a few different people in here. We got Cody. I hear
Cody. Hey, Cody. Alright.
Is Cody Riot or just a good friend?
Cody is part of the Wraith Guardians team.
Now it makes sense. Big shout out to Demorphic, who's apparently from Riot and enjoying the stream.
Hello.
Put in the good word for us, dude. I'd love to visit EU. Dreamhack. Anyways.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Looks like Strato, Utsuko, Lindos, and Lunatic are going to take Cody, and Holy Spork, Nugs, Polaris, Zeoman, Omnigamer is going to be the new teams. And Lindos left. What a jerk.
When is DreamHack?
I think it's in 2 weeks. Let me double check.
Really close.
So this weekend will be the 12th, 19th, 20th. Yeah, so 2 weekends.
I'm going to be at MLG, unfortunately.
Oh, it's a week. Okay, fine. Yeah. 3 weekends. I count 3 weekends. 2 weekends from this weekend.
Ah.
Okay. Yeah. Right, I'm fairly certain I'm not going. How about you?
I'm going to be at Providence.
Yeah, you're going to be at MLG, and I'm not.
It's still very unfortunate. Anytime either one of us are not in an event, unfortunate. Period.
Indeed. I'll go with that. I don't get any IP for spectating. WTF.
Lame. We sat through all of that.
I know, right?
We sat through all of that. We provided entertainment for everyone watching on Twitch, and we get no IP. That's cool. That's fine. disconnects. Always with the disconnects.
You disconnected. Lindos! I'm doing the whole Wrath of Khan thing right now. Lindos! I still hear the music. Whoa. Wait, you... I don't... I got my stream music going on. Rainwave doing amazing things. So let me get a Rainwave up here. There we go. Amazonia. Lost Eden. Never heard of it. It's kind of good music. Oh, Demorphic's coming to the US. Cool beans.
Nice.
Half my team crazy! Come on, Lindos, where'd you go? Did you actually not hear? Deathcap for Dorian added me today. Still don't know who that guy is. Lindos is here. He says he's playing. He got DC'd. Do we have to remake for that?
Don't think so.
Client closed and Stratto can't reinvite. Huzzah!
Yay.
Not really. Might have to get a sub. I don't know. How do you reset those, I wonder?
I don't know.
Yeah, me neither. Whole team crazy. Those are low ratings, says Viet Boy 5. I never claimed they were high. We got a 1440, it's good enough.
Yep.
Optimus Tom is actually doing some LOL as well. He was doing some Learn to LOL, I think it was his show. I don't know. He started it today. I gave him a retweet. Fortunately, I'm busy here with you, so.
That's what I do.
And you keep me busy.
That's just what I do. I keep everyone from doing everything important they ever want to do. That's how I know I'm doing my job.
Might just have to remake the game.
Yeah.
Oh, they got the MOG show going on right now. Fabian Cast starting up a new series of StarCraft. New game update to Rise of Immortals coming out.
Nice. I'm reading up on the...
Yeah, we're restarting the room, so...
Cool.
Head on out of that. Sorry about that, guys. Disconnect. We'll get it up. Don't worry. Game number 3 will happen. If there's anything I know how to do, it's stall. A lot of patience on that. Do you know how long Spectator Mode Beta will last? I heard 6 a.m., but that's EU time.
Yeah.
That'd be like 10 p.m. or so?
That sounds about right. So I think we can safely make this, I think we can make this our last one for tonight, probably.
Okay. Maybe.
That's our 3.
I might still hang out. I don't know. I don't know how long my wife's going to be away.
Well, we'll see how it goes. We might have a 20-minute surrender. You never know.
She's out Christmas shopping right now. So.
See, that's... That kind of... All the stores have their Christmas crap up already.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it used to be. It used to be the day after Thanksgiving. But now... Hey, guys. Halloween is in 2 weeks. Let's get our Christmas decorations up. Like...
Dude, people have had their Christmas stuff out since summer here.
What?
Yeah, arts and crafts stores. You could buy, like, wreaths and fake trees and ornaments and crap back in July. I know, right?
I
know.
Man. don't know. Every year, I'm just getting less and less excited for Christmas.
I know.
It's just like, man, it's been feeling like Christmas for 2 months. I'm kind of sick of it.
Oh, as long as they don't start playing the Christmas music like November 1st, then I'm.
Oh, too late! Too late! It says I went to the mall the week before Halloween, and they were running it. Yeah.
No, the week before Halloween.
Week before Halloween, Christmas music in the mall, Santa's lap thing was all set up. He wasn't even there, but just it's a principle. Damn you, Christmas.
Stratto. Yep.
Stratto Beach.
The only thing I get excited about now in Christmas is just like Summoner's Rift, winter version and the Haunt winter version. I know.
See, I mean, I was disappointed in the Halloween runes that they're like they're tier twos.
Tier 2.5s, okay.
Whatever. They weren't tier 3 runes, period. Like, last Christmas, they were tier 3s. That's how I cashed in. That's how I got pretty much, like, all the quints I needed.
God, why is there so much classical music on Rainwave right now? They had, like, a really good string of kick-ass music, and now it's, like, all classical. I don't know. So who are we missing here? I don't see Cody. Don't actually know where he went. And I don't know who James on a plane is, but we don't have Omni Gamer here either. Omni Gamer and Cody. I don't know. Rivington said he'd play, didn't he?
I believe Stratto said that, yeah.
We'll put up some IP rewards next game. Just name some names. Oh, that'd be cool, Matt. From Riot EU.
Hell yeah.
Remember. Somebody was requesting a song. Who am I to say no?
And IP rewards are always a good thing. You know, you can never have... You can never have too much IP.
You can never have too much IP. I second that, yeah.
Well, hey, that's... I've just been buying champs with IP this entire time.
I've actually spent money on this, and it was for my wife. She wanted Frankentimber's Annie.
Ah.
So, you know, I had to get it for her. Happy wife, happy life, you know?
Yep. See, I still contest, like, I have to agree with Riot, with Reddit on this. I still think that Frankenstein's Bride outfit would have looked a lot better on Karma.
European Community Manager at Riot Games, Matt Elliott. Well, thank you, Mr. Demorphic. You have more followers than me, you jerk.
There we go.
Who did they get in? Omnigamer and Cody. Oh, so they got in the people we were missing.
Yes.
Okay, so, just for... how long was that last game? Should be fine. I'm just thinking of the split. Split should be fine.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. 3, 2, 1. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. Game number 3 of the Spectator Madness going down here. FourCourtJester with the hat person once more. Dude, we're going to be like the next casting pair. Mark my words.
What? One day soon, I can feel it. I can feel it in my bones.
That's a song by Tegan and Sarah. And the only reason I know that is because of the girls at work. I had to put it in the disclaimer.
See, now I'm going to have to go on Spotify. Now I'm gonna listen to like one song. I'm gonna listen to like the entire freaking album. That's fine. It's fine.
No worries. Yeah. So game number 3. Stratto still organizing these games, but it is kind of almost a rematch. We got 8 of the 10 people from last game. We have 2 subs. So Cody is gonna be in here. Omnigamer gonna be in here, and they're gonna go head to head for a little bit of a rematch.
So we have very similar bans. You know, over these games. Like, Amumu's been banned pretty much every time.
Alan Graves.
Yeah, most of the bans on purple team are like, all right, who does Stratto use? Ban them. We're changing it up here, too.
Oh, no. I know what he's going to do. Remember when we did the whole Captain Barbossa series, or were you not part of that?
I don't think I was there for that.
Okay. This is what he did. He went AD crit armor pen Jarvan. Bottom lane with support. So he had like 43 armor penetration or something stupid, and he would just build straight crit. And while it is a face-melting maneuver, you're not the tankiest. You're pretty brittle. He ended up losing the game because he couldn't keep up with my last hits. I was Ash at the time, and we were all tryharding. So it didn't work out for him. I suspect we're going to see a similar thing.
Stratto be trolling.
I know.
I don't know.
I know.
But that is what Stratto does.
Indeed it is.
So I like this Galio pick. Because it's also kind of like it's almost like a counter to the Jarvan ult.
Ooh, Galio. Yes, very much so. Although they're probably suspecting Stratto to go with alone in the top lane. Although, knowing Stratto, he's probably not.
Yeah.
I don't think of... Okay, I've seen him top lane with Talon. That's it.
Let's see. I'm not sure how effective Warwick is going to be. I mean, he can get that Madras, and he can, you know, shred tank a little bit, but I'm not sure...
You don't really see Madras come out much for Warwicks anymore. It's all about the...
Really?
Tank. Well, it's all about the tank wick, right? So you'll get the Spear of Visage, you'll get the Sunfire, you'll get the Wit's End, then you usually get the Guardian's Angel, and then if the game is still going, you'll get a Madras.
Because usually, like, what I do in ranked is I'll pick Warwick if the other team picks someone super tanky like Singed. Rush Madras on him, and he just melts him. Melts him, melts him, melts him over and over.
Melt, right, melt, so
melt.
But we Warwick, got a Battle Cow, a support Battle Cow.
Alright, so yeah, so we have our established bot lane with these next two picks. We got our Caitlyn and Sona.
There it is, Vayne.
Vayne. Oh, Vayne Alistar, the combo.
Okay, so it looks like I might be wrong. Maybe Stratto is going to actually play normally for once and go top lane.
Stratto is starting out trolling.
Or we're going to let Vayne go do something crazy. I don't know what they want to do.
No, you know what? No, you have Alistar, Vayne, they have to go bot together. They have to. That's just a ridiculous...
So that means... But Lindos is a very capable top, so we might even see Stratto mid then.
This is true.
I don't know.
But, you know, you got Alistar, headbutt,
Kale,
eyes, Kale,
carry Kale.
Ooh,
interesting.
We could be seeing.
I suspect Kale's going top.
Could mid.
Well, we don't actually have a mid here, so what depends on really what mid does the purple want. I mean, they got their Caitlyn Sona, so they're clearly going bottom. Polaris is going top. They don't have a jungle, actually, so Polaris might be going mid, or Galio's going mid, mage in the middle.
I can see Galio top. Wait, no, you're right. Galio mid, Relia top. What's Omni going to do?
So, well, if Omni is not jungling, yeah, he's going to
jungle. There we go, jungle.
So, you know, going with the whole mage in the mid, well, if we're going to go with mage in the mid, Kale and Galio should butt heads, and that would leave Stratto versus Irelia, but... I know Stratto's very atypical, so...
Mm-hmm.
There we go. Okay, so that's what they're going to do. Olaf jungle to counter the Warwick. I do like Olaf picks. I've noticed he's been played a little bit more often now in the higher tiers ever since his remake on his ultimate, because now he can break out of the CC effects.
Right.
But, you know, it's a shorter cooldown, so it's a little easier to predict when you can then CC him again. So we'll have to see how this works. It is not a 10 flash game. We actually have 3 ghosts on the table.
Ghost on Olaf, ghost on...
Kale and...
Kale, Stratto.
Stratto, yeah. Jarvan, no, Stratto.
Yeah. Stratto is Jarvan.
Oh, there's that sneaky dark sniper's actually in the chat now. And like, Stratto can't match that. I was too good. Did play very well, I'll give him that. Yeah. So I'm fairly sure the Twitch VOD will not cut off at the 2-hour mark, because I don't think I've been streaming for 2 hours on this specific game, so I should be able to export everything to YouTube, and I'll do that tonight so we can process overnight. People on my YouTube are going to be happy if I want to get content to it. Oh, he took a phone call and got replaced. Oops.
Uh-oh.
Alright, so Galio's taking teleport. That does not necessarily mean he's going top, although it is a strong indication. Because Irelia's going to be very far removed from everyone if she doesn't. Either way, though, Irelia's very used to that top lane solo, and they do suspect, or at least they should suspect, they're going up against Stratto. So, I don't know. We might see some discussion going on. We might see some lane swapping going on. They're kind of very weird picks.
Yeah, it's going to be strange for the purple team. Whoever goes mid is going to have... Well, you actually, you know, it's we have strange... We have a strange mid and top lane no matter what.
So what happens when you ban out, like, three of the favorite heroes of the game.
That is what happens. That is indeed what happens. But, you know, I think I'm going to have to give mid and top advantage over to the purple team, though. Because, mainly, I'm not sure. I'm not sure about Kayle. I'm really not. I may be eating my words.
Well, KO is a decent hybrid. I mean, you get her a Rageblade or a Nashor's. Yeah.
Rageblade. Rageblade on Kayle. Holy crap, man.
Oh, yeah. No, it does.
Holy crap.
Maladies. That's a good one, too.
Mm-hmm.
Or though you could just... After that, you could just go, like, straight AD, like Bloodthirsters.
Right.
It's really crazy because, you know, with your nuke on your Q, you do... I think it's your Q. Because you'll do increased damage now. And, you know, you get your splash going. With enough cooldown reduction, you can actually eat that up 100% later into the game.
Nice.
I know. It when played right, it is a really, really scary build. Unfortunately, you don't see a lot of people playing it right because it's kind of hard to execute. But we'll have to see. We still got 30 seconds. They really give you a lot to talk about in 3 minutes, don't they?
I know. It's just... But you know what? It's something that needs to be done. You know,
I like
the best,
it, yeah.
The best casters out there, you know, you gotta find a nice creative way to kill time sometimes, you know? I mean, imagine, you know, going to a live event, internet goes down, stuff like that. You gotta be fresh, you gotta be entertaining, you gotta be funny, you gotta be not silent.
No, pretty much, yeah.
It's rough to be a caster sometimes, you know.
Sometimes. I would rather be a caster than the pro player. There's a lot less stress.
Really?
In my opinion, yeah. That's just me, though. All right, yeah. So guys, game number 3 about to go underway here. Jarvan, Alistar, Warwick, Kayle, and Vayne up against the Irelia, Galio, Caitlyn, Sona, Olaf. And we're going to get this Rowan grudge match number 2. Right now, we did have purple team in the lead from the last game because they are up 1-0. Two subs are now in, and HatPerson and FourCourtJester are going to take you all the way to the end.
And right there, just by looking at the loading screen, I can already tell Stratto's team is going to win because they won the skin war.
Let's see. Jarvan, Alistar, Warwick, Kayle, and Vayne. And Tisk, Galio, and Caitlyn. A little slow
five,
there.
Five skins versus 3 skins. Stratto, you already win. You can just close out the client now. Bye, you know. Night, everyone. No.
Predictable. The whole skin to win mentality coming through.
Yeah.
I like that Olaf skin, though. Reminds me of, like, those ice ogres from Thor.
Yeah, it's unfortunate the rest of the movie sucked.
It wasn't the best, was it?
No, it wasn't.
I saw it, like, in a plane, and I was like, really glad I didn't buy or go to see that. Yep.
Yeah, I have some friends, they happen to have, they convinced a movie theater to have a Marvel vs. Capcom 3 tournament.
Oh, that's awesome.
And then we all watched Thor afterwards, and then we all just, it was like, well, we were there. Might as well watch
Might
the movie.
Might as well, yeah.
Immediately regretted it.
You can rent out those theaters for, like, Xbox parties. I've always wanted to do that, but it's, like, so much money.
Yeah, it's...
I just want to be up there on Halo, like, a whole screen to myself, you know?
I still remember the, what is it, the football stadium for the Dallas Cowboys? They have the Godzillatron, or whatever it's called.
I have no idea what that is.
It's the world's largest 1080p monitor.
Wow, Godzillatron, that's an apt name for it.
I think that's what it's called. I'll have to look it up. But here's the thing. It's so large that people are actually, you know, teams are actually hitting it with the football during kickoffs. It's like bouncing off of it.
Oh, that's perfect.
Oh.
All right, so game has started here, guys. We got a little old
So we got
Warwick.
We got some insight to the Kale pick.
Oh,
and
did?
That was the glitched client.
So it was random?
It was randomed.
Okay, that's... so here we are analyzing it like idiots.
Oh, well, it's, you know, sometimes, you know, the simple answer is usually the correct one.
Hey, whoa, nobody disconnected.
Hey, we're getting places.
Yeah, buddy,
we're getting places.
Unfortunately, we have a Kale.
Yeah, no one disconnected, but we had a random pick.
Yeah, all right.
So that's the trade-off this time.
Fair enough.
But we see a lot more mobilization in the jungle for this game, though.
Where's the Lidos going?
Okay. Except for Kale. No.
Like, did he bug out again? Is he just going to kill himself? I don't know. Yeah, right now, you know, big protection going down to the blue. Warwick, of course, really, really wants that blue. Makes jungling a lot easier for him. And, I mean, do we have clear points, as I believe, on each team, right? One on the Cow, one on the Sona. Sona's already blown hers. So they're probably going to find this defensive jungle, no problem. Polaris up top, so it is going to be Aurelia top and the Galio in the mid. And I'm not too sure if they've discussed who they want to go mid, although it does look like Jarvan is going to go top, so he is going to kind of just play normal.
So Jarvan Aurelia is going to be a nice lane. So Kale Galio. Can't say I've ever seen this matchup before.
Kale versus Galio. Yeah, well, that was a first for everything.
But, you know, I think Kale is actually going to have the advantage here because of her E.
So the splash?
Yeah, the splash, yeah. That's going to do dividends for her.
Yeah, Q is your nuke. Okay, cool. Alright, so Jarvan versus Aurelia top. Aurelia does have that Doran's shield up against the lifesteal here from Jarvan, so we're going to have to see how that works. And Olaf, you know, he's just happily gotten his blue. He's going to be doing work. And Caitlyn versus Vayne. I've always been a big fan of Vayne against Caitlyn because I always hate going against Vayne as Caitlyn. So I suspect that they'll be able to do work, but a lot of spam should be coming out of this Nugs the Pirate Holy Spork lane. I mean, we got the Cow that has to get in close for the spam versus the long-rangeness of the Caitlyn Sona.
I like this bot lane a lot because both teams have warded the opposite bush. Everyone knows where everyone is at all times. And for those who don't know, Alistar Vayne is a ridiculously deadly combo bot lane. How it goes, Alistar will come in, headbutt you to the wall, immediately pulverize, Vayne will come around, and she will shoot you with her E and send you into the wall again, stunning you.
It's like having two poppies at your face.
That's not pleasant at all.
No.
That's never pleasant. And Stratto comes in. Man,
he's been keeping her low. I've been keeping back and forth looking for the first blood. But yeah, he's been doing good work up here. He's already pushed her back, picks up the first. Did not even use... Well, he doesn't have Ignite, never mind. He has... Yeah. Flash and Ghost. But he used the Flash to get away from the tower at the end there, but that's going to be great for him. Picks up a Doran's Blade, going to head right back to town.
Yep, and Kale Galio, this is actually a nice even match we got going on here.
Yeah, I mean, Galio does have his shield, and Lindos has to, you know, wait for the E cooldown, so it's not going to be constant harass. In terms of last hits, though, a little bit later on, I do suspect Galio should just be able to clear them out with his combos after he gets himself a tier.
This Olaf's coming around, though. Lindos doesn't have any idea.
We
Olaf's got double
blue.
Buff.
Yep. Oh, he's going right over to
he's
him!
Going right over. Nah, get that sun. Get with the Q.
It's going to be fine. He missed the axe, and that's the important part.
Yeah.
All right, Boots picked up.
That's the unfortunate thing about any junglers. You have, like, skill shots like Olaf or Lee Sin.
Yeah, if it doesn't hit.
You miss that skill shot, you might as well just get out.
Yeah. I like how he went and retrieved his axe before leaving. Now, one thing that Stratto didn't do is buy a ward, so he's going to have
idea. So he also doesn't have any idea that the Olaf's coming up right behind him now. Get the stun. Get the axe. This time it hits.
We got the ghost, but we do not have the flash.
Oh! Does not get a chance to go over to the standard before he falls.
Yeah.
It was like he was like in mid-animation as that was happening.
Now, you saw she started going off really aggressive. And Stratto should have been ticked off. He's like, well, I just beat her. Why is she going aggressive? And again, no ward. This is something we saw in the previous games. Every time somebody died, they would pick up a ward and immediately ward that area. And that is something that Stratto did not pick up on there. So he's going to go down, but unfortunately, he still got a little bit of gold before he died, and he has a second Doran's Blade. Really trying to prove himself very annoying in this top lane.
Yep. Now Galio decided to go back. He's got himself a Chalice and his tier 1 boots.
Chalice is
going to
be
teleports, teleports right back, trying to get more harass onto this Kayle.
Warwick covering the top lane, like a good little Warwick. Level 5, I don't think he's actually gone back to town, because he still has the cloth armor and a pot. So that's actually good if he has not gone back to town. He's kind of keeping average here with Omnigamer.
And bottom lane's kind of boring.
Yeah, but everyone's, they saw the Olaf coming, so they're not going to get caught by that, which is good. Creep kills, 42 for Caitlyn, 36 for Vayne, so a little bit of an advantage being created there.
So now for this ward placement. Down here, bot river. Now you have the blue team warded directly in front of dragon. Purple team warded, you know, directly in front of the little entrance there in the bush. What I see a lot of pro teams do is the ward ideally should actually go in between where those two wards are currently placed, so that way you have vision on both entrances to the jungle blue over here and to this little intersection, this tri-intersection over here, so you can get vision on both.
You say over here, but that doesn't help me.
Because, right, you can see the pings right there.
I can't see pings, no.
Oh, you can't? No.
I don't...
But you see,
here's
you see...
a ping, can you see that?
I
just pinged. Nah, I don't think spectators can ping. That's probably built in to stop the ghosting as well.
Ah.
Yeah, sorry about that.
But anyway, those both of those wards at bottom, if you can see both of those, ideally a ward in bot lane should actually go right in between where they're placed.
Now Stratto's trying to do some juking here. He is on the, you know, escape here from Omnigamer, but I do think Omnigamer is probably going to grab this, but look at that! The invulnerability coming out from
Perfect
Lindos.
Hold on, Stratto.
Lunatic coming in here, and Gale! Galio going for the taunt. This might be a dead Lunatic. Oh, great flash. Got out of that nuke.
That's,
no,
that was a little bit of a delayed ult on the part of Galio.
I think he was trying to grab Jarvan, though.
I think he was, but you know what? Everyone got away.
Good team support, good communication there.
Yep, that definitely did go in purple team's favor, though.
And now this, I really is just really starting to
now,
get...
I don't know why this Kayle's still around, though. She should have backed.
Yeah, she should have backed. She has no heal? Oh, she does have a heal, yeah, but it's level 1. Oh, I wouldn't back there. Galio's just...
Keep going. Yeah. Go further back.
Well, with two kills now on this Aurelia, I mean... She's at 14 creep kills, Jarvan's at 24, but he does have 2 kills to his name. His farm is far surpassing hers. I mean,
gold on both teams is actually pretty even right now.
8.7,
so
8.6. Yep. 61 creep
Jarvan
kills for Caitlyn,
50 Jarvan's
for
pursuing this. But he realizes, you know, he's at tower, he sees all these creeps. That's just, you know, one hit to take away. That's very efficient farming right there.
We got Lunatic here covering the mid, getting some solo EXP, has to dodge the skill shots, but Kayle's going to come on right back. Has a blasting wand, so it's going to start up maybe that Rage Blade first item.
I think we're going for Rage Blade first, because Edna and I approve of that very much so. You know, she is a hybrid. You got to build both, and Rage Blade's a very efficient item to do it. Same thing with Gunblade, if you can get it.
Now what is Olaf going to do? Goes back town, gets himself a Wriggles, 2 wards, no boots. So he's going to still be a little bit slower through that jungle, not going to be as easy to get to these lanes, but with the Wriggles, he now has a lot of sustainability in that jungle. It should prove very useful for him, but that's the trade-off, right?
Cody, bottom lane, taking way too many hits than he should. Alistar steps in, Caitlyn used her ult.
Yep, good on Alistar, being a good beefy tank.
That's a good cow.
Good cow.
Good cow.
Pat him on
the head. Good cow. Good cow.
Mulissa. Yeah. You ever seen Bob's Burgers? Hilarious episode of the cow.
I've seen a few episodes. I enjoy the voice actors.
Archer is amazing. Yeah.
Archer's fantastic.
It's the same voice actor. Yeah.
Yes, he is. We actually speaking of cows, we actually have like a local like supermarket chain here, Stu Leonard's, where they have like these animatronic cows like throughout the entire supermarket.
Kind of creepy.
They're very creepy. If you're like from like the 70s, the same animatronics.
Check out top.
Uh oh. Uh oh.
We really want the kill here.
Now you missed the ult.
No, he didn't.
Stratto walks back into
it. No, he didn't miss the ult. He flashed as it went down. It was drawn back towards him.
Wow, I didn't even know he could do that.
It's like when I use my arcane shift on Ezreal after a poppy charges me, I actually shift out, but then my character model resets to wherever I'm getting slammed by poppy. Similar idea there. It's just a matter of time.
And it's coming right back down for the attempt on Kale. You know, we got that. You got that momentum. You might as well keep using it.
Did he say anything in chat about it?
I
call BS on that ult. Yeah. So he actually got taunted before the flash went off.
That, I have to agree that was a little bit of BS, but you know. Hey,
I
unfortunate
say the same thing too.
We got the Warwick. Can he come in for the ult on Galio? He's decided not to.
Okay, I guess he didn't. I thought I saw the animation go down. I was going to say the same thing just happened there.
Oh, look, we have an Olaf in our jungle.
Taking
our red. And actually, we have a blue team.
Oh, he's going to give it to Caitlyn.
Ooh, that's even sneakier.
No, he's not. Never mind.
Scumbag Olaf.
Yeah. Scumbag Olaf.
I took it for myself.
New
map. But look at this though. Purple team, they have a Caitlyn trap in that tribush, two wards in their jungle.
Yep,
ward on the south
offensive.
River.
Pretty offensive.
And guess how many wards blue team has?
Zero.
Zero.
Yep. Now Stratto again, you know, playing his very normal aggressive self up here. He is level 9 compared to the level 8 here of Polaris simply because of those extra ganks. And, I mean, that was a very offensive teleport we saw as well from Zeelman. And it was perfectly timed as well because it was right there in the bush. Again, Stratto has no wards to his name. As he just pointed out, we got zero blue team wards. And if you're going to be pushing that much, it might be very worthwhile to invest.
Yeah, something I've noticed, we got something happening in bot lane. We got a lot of people down here. 3v3 situation, but purple team just found out. Just found out that it was a 3v3 with ICV.
Oh, I really actually winning the war top.
Thank you, Tower.
Stop pinging bottom when Stratto kills things. God. But this might actually mark the downfall of Stratto. If he can no longer tower dive her and he plays really aggressive, that's going to lead to a lot of unnecessary.
So it's a 4v3 in bottom lane, and purple team's deciding to go for dragon. Sona gang focused down by Vayne, taking quite a bit of damage. Galio goes down on both of them.
That's a dead
guy. I thought Vayne was escaped from that. I thought she was just like right on the edge. Sona ult, sure why that happened.
Yeah.
But hey, we can still catch up to this.
Did you see Warwick actually use the flash for initiation and then he didn't do anything?
Oh!
That was pretty pro, gotta say.
Doesn't you know, he shot it before he was pushed back, so it just goes the full distance.
Yep.
Hell,
a matter of timing with these things. I mean, that's
doing work with that Q, man.
And that's going to be the end of the bottom tower.
Can we get the second one? Can we do something with this?
Well, we still got Vayne dead. Cal is now up.
Warwick's kind of confused as what he should be doing.
Yeah, I noticed that. He's kind of just wandering around. But with Lindo's down here, we can easily push mid.
He doesn't... Well, now he knows that bush is warded. But
that's a bad idea.
Little does blue team know how much...
Oh, lunatic.
Come on. No, he's
totally.
Galio, you jerk. That was all Caitlyn.
Ruining our day. Oh no, Stratto coming in here.
Stratto sees the whole team there, but still decides to go after Galio.
He's okay. He's good.
He's okay. He's good.
Well, the problem is now that Aurelia has free run.
Right.
And now she has a kill over top of Stratto. And Stratto's melting. You see
and blue team is getting all of their, you know, their position is known at all times. They have their jungle's warden. They don't even really know it.
Those wards are actually done.
Yeah. Well, for them, how many more wards? How many wards is
Blue team still has zero. I'll give you that.
Yeah.
But now these wards are now.
Alstar's had the green and purple ward in his inventory for a while now. Hasn't really placed them anywhere.
I think he's actually just picked a few more of those up. But you're right, you haven't played some. Might actually go for it now. Nope, never mind. Wants to stick around. Either way, look at it this way. It's 6-2. We're down 2.5k. Aurelia is now starting to get free farm coming back into this game, so that early advantage that Stratto created is now slowly slipping away from him. And I gotta say, I am still right, however, to say that he's going a full AD route, build.
Right.
I mean, look at that. No GP10, no tankiness, no Triforce. And I did notice, like, he's not running any kind of attack damage runes or whatever. He's probably full armor pet.
Yep. And look, you know, Stratto up top. I mean, he was winning the battles early on, but I think he overall may be losing the war.
He is now.
Look how much he's being shaved by that Aurelia. You know, Lunatic came in for the Warwick ult, didn't really do much because Stratto was
farming,
otherwise distracted. Dalio teleports into the ward up top. Little do they know the situation they're about to be in.
Oh, they know there was a clairvoyance.
There's a CV. Stratto has to back. So this is still a 3v3 up top.
No, Strato's not playing Jarvan like a bruiser. He's playing him as an AD carry. And as I said, like, he's done this to me before. It didn't work out.
Right. It was
again, it's not working out.
Extremely effective early game. But as we're now in mid-game and heading into late-game, it's now going to taper off extremely quick.
And do you know why it's now tapering off? Like, we're only 16 minutes into this game. It's still, by all means, considered early to mid. But
right.
Do you know why it's tapering off so very quickly? It's because, A, there's no wards. B, he's just being really aggressive. And they're just playing pretty normally and very supportive. So, I mean, he's died a whole bunch of times. Like, he's about to die again. Oh, that's Kale and Warwick. Oh,
yeah.
Well, okay, fine. They still die. Jarvan actually is nowhere near here. Notice he's bottom?
Yeah, I see him bottom, trying to get that Sona. Not doing much. Alistar coming around.
I really
but
go
that tower is going to be down before he can actually even really do anything. He can come in, pulverize, maybe get him off once or twice, miss the pulverize. But
see, this is why I really expected Jarvan to go bottom, because he's not going to be playing this as a bruiser. He's going to play it as an AD carry. I don't know why Utsikal's still here. I mean, that's just a terrible idea.
He's going to get pursued down.
Yeah.
Aurelia had the vision,
that
so
was four
she just.
Kills none. And a tower.
Was.
And a tower. All Jarvan did was get a few creeps, bottom, and now he's going mid for some reason. So, yeah. Oh, wow, that Olaf hurt.
Good, now that's a good ult, but since Olaf was in his ult, he did not get the pop up.
Wow. That Olaf.
That's Olaf with his new ultimate change, man.
Crazy. Either way, it's still not looking good for blue team. 9-3, the gold lead's now 4k. Dragon should be up next in a few minutes.
Mm-hmm.
This Jarvan is not going to be winning that lane whatsoever. Cody actually picked up the kill there, has himself a nice blue buff, and seems to be playing a lot more standard. Now, Doran's Blade, Berserker's BF Sword, how much gold does he have right now?
He's got a little bit over 1,000.
And that's going to be a Cleaver. Good on you.
So we have who do we got? We got Cleaver versus Bloodthirster.
What, the argument? Or
No, we have Cleaver on Vayne, okay. We have Bloodthirster on Caitlyn.
Gotcha. I didn't know what we were talking about.
But here's the thing, I think Cleaver is actually going to do a little bit better.
For Vayne,
For the blue team in general. You got Jarvan, and you got Warwick coming in and doing their things.
Lindo still doesn't have anything past his blasting wand.
Mm. Oh, Lindo's has got some money saved up. You got about 1,300 right now. So she hasn't, Kale hasn't really backed recently. But, you know, we've got this huge, massive push mid. Aurelia's just to top, free farming. Jarvan in
so
base
close.
Trying to catch up.
Oh, Utsikal Blue is ultimate just to survive. Not even going to initiate with it. Oh.
Can't. You can't do it. Because, you know, you got that Galio ult. Something to be afraid of,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, that's good counter-initiation right there. Now, Stratto might try to think what he wants to do. Here it is, that last whisper, as I said, he wants to go a full armor pen, right? He picked up
Stratto's in hiding, waiting for the time to do his ultimate. A little bit too late, but you know what? He's going to go for it anyway.
Oh, good trap right there. He does blow it. Omni Gamer's going to go down. Stratto's going to grab that kill. We're still within tower range, but it just melts so very quickly.
I can't believe, you know, Olaf in his ult, there's not really a whole lot that Stratto can do. Stratto's, you know, pop-up just doesn't work on him. his ult, you know, I mean, he's still going to deal damage to him, but he's not going to get, you know, as many benefits as he would if Olaf wasn't as an ult. And he focuses him first. Oh, I think, you know, the person... Actually, there's not really anyone that they could really prefer to focus, because they're all doing really well.
I mean, check out the gold. It's spent 8k now. I mean, general, 5,000, 6,000, 6,000, 4, and 5. We got 2,000 here for the count, 3,000 for Warwick. Right?
Yeah.
That's a lot of ore.
And what's Galio going? Was that a DC? That's a DC. That has to be a DC.
Where was Galio? I didn't even see him.
He was just chilling.
Very likely.
Right then. Yeah.
Lindos has his Rage Blade now, though.
Yes, that's good.
Has been 20 minute mark. That's about the good timestamp you want to try to beat. Get that first item by 20 minutes.
So now let's put us into the position of the blue team.
Okay.
We get into another team fight. Who's the first target?
Sona or Caitlyn? They're the squishier of the two. And I mean, Irelia is pretty hefty at this point. 1,800 hit points. She has herself a Sheen in that phage, and of course heightened style, lots of stunning. But her ultimate, I mean, is just not going to be as damaging. Caitlyn can just sit back and pick people off of their range, and Sona does all those healings, all those buffs, and the AoE ult. Yeah. So if you need to pop up someone to death, I would say one of those two.
Because what we've seen in, you know, the major team fights thus far, the major focus has actually been Olaf.
Galio did this, point, which is kind of weird.
Yeah. And then both times, Olaf just ulted, got out of CC, and just went on his Viking day.
That's why Olaf's becoming more and more popular, because that change to his ult.
It's just one little change does so much for him. So I think, you know, if... I'm not saying this is insurmountable for blue team, it's a very steep hill, but if we can focus down Sona and Caitlyn, we might be able to make a change for the better.
It also really should come down to Lindos actually using his ults and picking the right target to use it on. I mean, in these, I wanted to call them cluster Fs, but I'm not going to call them that. In these big team encounters where things get messy, you know, who do you use it on? Do you use it on yourself for the sustainability? Are you stunned? Can you even use it? Like, there's no silences right now, but we do got taunts and AoE stuns.
So, right, like, I mean, I would be looking...
Did you even see it last fight, for example?
No,
I'm not sure I did.
I'm not sure if I did either. Yeah. But if I were Kale, and if I were to be using my ult, I would prefer to use it on Vayne.
Not good.
That's a flash.
Not good.
That's
wow.
A flash.
Wow.
1, 2, 3.
Well, there's that, actually, there's Lindos ult right there.
And Olaf is just going to come in, smack.
And that's why you go ghost on Olaf.
Yeah.
That was terrible.
Yeah. Well, that's... Well, I mean... See, that's what wards do. Wards win games. They had the ward in the S bush behind the wolves.
Yep.
They had perfect vision. And when they were approaching, so Galio could just flash ult.
Well, so Lindos just went too far. I think they put down this ward here, and Galio and Jarvan were up in this little tuft in the river. And that was just a little bit too far over extension. We had to use the flashes to get out, and that's when we saw, hey, they're in disarray. We're going to jump in there. And
did it perfectly.
16-5 now. Very convincing.
Stratto's kind of trapped outside of his own base.
He's not.
Well, he can't exactly get back in.
He goes a long way. Or he could just do nothing.
Jarvan's outside the base. It's like he locked himself out of his house. Like trying to knock on the window. He's like trying to get the attention of the cat to like open the door somehow.
Now what he could have done.
Mickey, let me in.
He could have went north to intercept the creep wave.
He could have.
But instead.
But
he decided
to just kinda watch.
He went the ultra long way around.
Yeah.
Alright. Inhibitors down. Turrets down. The teammates are still just respawning. We might have had a good chance to go grab that Baron. I mean, we do a lot of damage between the five of us on the purple team.
Yeah.
But looks like they will go grab their gold, their items, pack those up. They might still assemble for a Baron. I'm still not too sure there's too much blue team can do about it at this point. Oh, well, that's going to be...
Caitlyn's getting caught here.
Oh!
Her knocks her out.
Oh, that was so close.
She did waste her flash.
Notice how she died on the other side of that flash?
She did die on the other side of the flash. She, oh.
Again, remember, it does not projectile pop. This is why, you know, you get taunted and the flash still goes off. Doesn't matter. It does not break the effect. You get hit as you flash. Doesn't matter. The damage is still going to hit you.
The only, I believe the only effect that cancels during flash is turret focus. On occasion.
Not if it's still
I've seen it happen a few times.
If it's going to shoot you, and the projectile has already left the turret, and you flash, you're still going to get hit.
You're still going to get hit, but you will lose aggro if someone else is around.
Aggro.
Aggro to mob. Aggro to mob. More dots. More dots.
More dots.
More dots. Less dots.
Minus 50 dick.
Oh, the good old days.
Yeah, the good old days. My university days.
I do not miss raiding.
I kind of miss it, but...
I don't.
I kind of miss 40-man raiding as we watch Utsuko close ult and still die.
Yeah. There's not worth taking out the ward.
He took the ward, but hey, he gave them a Baron.
This is true.
No clairvoyance? Oh, look at that! Oh! I really expected everybody to actually jump across that those tree lines right there.
Yeah, I was kind of waiting for it.
Soda,
flash!
Lunatic has got to get back to his team. Although, it does look like Mane took out...
Oh! Olaf. Clutch ultimate windows.
Where is
like,
Mane?
The ultimate was popped way like mid projectile.
I did not even see that fight going on, but hey, that's really good news for Mane right there. I guess
they're just kind of push around.
Yeah, they're going to push top.
They're going to push top. They're going to take out that tower. You know, even though Olaf is down for the moment, after they take out this tower, I think they should be in good position for Baron.
Olaf is up in 5. You can easily meet them there.
Purple team's still in great position for Baron.
We got the mid creep wave that's just going to push itself down. We do got the top pressure they have to deal with. Bottom is actually being pushed in as well. That turret
Bottom's almost done.
Yeah,
this
that
next
turret
wave.
Might drop. Free gold
this
in your
next
pockets.
Wave should take it out.
Free gold in your pockets there.
Hey, that's never a bad thing.
Yeah.
Free money.
I don't miss raiding in Wrath of the Lich King or Cataclysm or whatever the third expansion was. I don't remember. But, you know, TBC days, which 25 were pretty fun. The 40 days is forever going to be in my memory. It's awesome. Back in the day, 40-man raids on Blackwing Lair, man, that was me. That was me. I really enjoyed that time. But it's behind us now.
Yeah, I mean, actually, I saw the announcement yesterday.
Pandaria?
For Lineage 3.
Oh, yeah, I saw a Twitter about that as well.
See, that was me and my sister all the time. Like, those raids were interesting.
I have no idea.
Because it was the raids were like castles in towns.
Ooh, Stratto with the ult does that, miss that, everyone. Now he's dead.
Was that an interrupted Galio ult?
It might have been. Oh, Stratto gets the invulnerability from Lindo's. Utsuko is still here for some reason. Although we do got those exhausts going on. Lots of deaths. Blue team coming
How
out.
How did Stratto... Wow. The there.
4-2.
How did Stratto live for that long?
Omni Gamer in the bottom, man. Oh, he is doing the split push. And he will get this tower.
I don't know. It's going to be really close. He decides to back off. Wow.
Stratto lived that long simply because Lindos threw the invulnerability out on him. That's
what
I was talking
fantastic.
About a little bit
that
earlier.
Was close. That was really close. Like, how much health did he have? Like, under 200?
Well, the cow was straddling on death for the longest of times.
I know. Wow.
But the cow does go down. Stratto eventually does go down. I think he died to creeps. But, you know, whoever hit him last got the kill. And, yeah, Lindos coming out with the clutch ultimate there. They won that fight 4-2, even if they did lose one of these towers. And they're about to lose the dragon.
Right. So now, purple team, they're pinging. They want Baron. Because if they grab Baron right now, they can just go ahead and push for the win.
I don't know. Strato's got to be feeling good about that. I mean, after Strato's, that last whisper, he almost has that Infinity Edge now.
Good.
Remember,
good
he's
on him.
Not playing a Bruiser. He's playing it AD, guys, if you're just tuning in.
So see, how much... Let's see, take a look at his damage output right now. His Q does about 400. His ultimate on land... does about 600, and that's of course before armor.
And then you collapse the wall. Doesn't the collapse the wall do more damage, or do they remove that?
Well,
not when you blew it up, it did more damage, but I guess not.
Nah.
Okay, fine, whatever. Flags right. for 240, it doesn't really scale with anything. And, yeah, Golden Aegis, it's fine.
Right.
All right.
So Purple Team's setting up for Baron.
I think they're setting up for a bait on Baron, to be honest.
They know... And, you know, they're both teams are very aware about the general area they're in, because, you know...
Our inhibitor is up.
Blue team is anxious to engage, but we're trapped at blue.
Goodbye, Ward.
But say, yeah, their inhibitor is being pushed in. They have no choice but to go back or lose
the
inhib.
Yeah, the longer they're out of base, the more this inhibitor is going to go down, because it still has to deal with these super creeps. But the inhibitor is up, that's the important part.
They get vision on the inhibitor, they decide to go in on it.
The cow is still here.
And the ship
is
down in no time. And they're just going to have... They have no choice but to watch it fall.
Yep. That's good timing there on Purple's part.
Fantastic timing attack on Baron.
Get Baron out of it, even though everyone is alive. Yep.
That's
how you want to set that up.
That's exactly how you want to set that up. Because
like
inhibitors can't stay down forever. Yep. When they do come back up, you still have a good two waves of super minions still coming in and attacking it. And those waves have to be taken care of. Otherwise, the inhibitor's just going to go right back down again.
Sonic the Hedgehog music. Brilliant. yeah, so we might have saved it, but guess what?
It's going to go right back down again.
So that now brings up the question. Was it worth going back to save it, only to give them free Baron and then lose it? Or should they have just gone for the kills, lose it anyways, and possibly win a Baron out?
Right.
You got to really... That's one of those retrospectives. You know, did we make the right call? I'm not going to say yes or no. I think I would have went for the kills myself, but...
Same here.
I understand the mentality of wanting to try to get back into the game.
Right. I think now we're just kind of, you know, biding our time.
Well, now you got to bide your time. They have
we're just waiting for the right time to push, because there are all five of them in their base, and they're all just outside waiting to see which entrance they should be pushing.
They're like those peeping Toms looking in windows.
Now, actually, I think top lane... would actually be the ideal one to look at. Because bot lane...
Oh, we have no turrets.
Look at the top lane turret in health comparison to the bottom turret.
That's about to
now,
go down.
The thing is, though, they, you know, blue team has a wave pushing to the purple top turret, but Galio could just go in and tank it for, what, a second?
Good.
But then we just force our way in through bottom also.
Yeah, I mean, they're not... I mean, even if they lose that one turret, they're going to gain so much from this. So, you know, ignoring it is really what you
there's
want
not,
to do.
Yeah, and there's not really much blue can do against this team with
one
Baron.
One kill, two kill. Two. Strato going to go in.
Galio's just taking that turret the entire time.
He doesn't care. Oh, big crits coming out there. That's going to be an ace. Oh, maybe. Whoa,
wow,
so
Cody. Almost died in spawn. Never mind.
Doesn't. Very likely
this is GG.
GG. I don't see anything coming out in the chat, but... Ooh, a triple kill? Triple kill from Spork right there. Good stuff. Alright, so... If there's anything to take from this, guys, Stratto played the Jarvan very atypically. He did not go the bottom lane like I kind of predicted. He went pure AD with the armor pen. It doesn't work, okay?
But, well, it's not that it doesn't work. It's that it's a very early game-minded build.
Yeah, but he got shut down really hard.
Yeah.
They
shut down.
Recognized the threat, and they came together and they did it.
But more importantly, wards win games,
very
people.
Big
wards win games.
That person dropping knowledge right there, guys.
All over. Wards all over. Drop knowledge like you should wards. Everywhere.
Do it up everywhere, exactly. That's not the right thing. That's the right thing. There we go. Alright guys, game number 3, the grudge match is going to settle at 2-0 here for Nugs the Pirate and Holy Spork and Friends. So, I don't know if they're going to do any more. You sticking around, you're not sticking around?
You know what?
Let's find out
before we call it.
Alright, we'll find out, then we'll call it, guys. And, you know, HatPerson, FourCourtJester, we're just hanging out having fun with the Spec client mode. It's good time.
Hell yeah.
Here's a quick break, we're going to check in, see what we can do. Be right back.